Hello students, today we are going to consider the next example from the exercise 2.6, the example number 6 and example number 7, actually which are word examples. That means first of all we have to convert the statement into linear equation form and then we have to solve, that means we have to obtain the value of variable. So here the first example is like this, the question number 6 is like this. The ages of Hari and Harry, these are the two persons whose ages are in the ratio 5:7. So ratio of their present ages was given. 4 years from now, that means after the 4 years, that means we have to add this value. So 4 years from now, the ratio of their ages will be 3:4. And then we have to find out their present ages. We have to find out their present ages with the help of these given conditions. So here, as the ratio is given, so that's why, as in the earlier examples, we have seen that the common ratio between their ages is going to be x. Whenever some ratio is given, then the common ratio between those ratios, we are taking it as a x. So therefore, common ratio between their ages is going to be x. And as their present ages are in the ratio 5:7, so therefore, Hari's age and Harry's age is going to be 5x and 7x. 5:7. So x is a common ratio. So 5 into x is the 5x and 7 into x is 7x years respectively. And 4 years later, we have to just add the 4 to both these ages. That means 5x plus 4 is the age of Hari and 7x plus 4 is going to be age of Harry. And now their ratios are 3:4. So therefore we can write down 5x plus 4 divided by 7x plus 4, which is equals to 3/4. Now here you can perform the simplification. That means you can simplify this equation by performing two types of operations. The first one is that you can multiply both sides by denominator, or the second thing is that you can transpose these denominators to other sides. So both ways are acceptable, no problem. So here I am using the method multiplying both sides by denominators, so which is 4 into 7x plus 4. So combiningly we have to multiply RHS as well as LHS denominator. We have to combine and we have to multiply by that factor to both sides. So after multiplying, we are getting the simplified form like this. 4 into 5x plus 4, which is equals to 3 into 7x plus 4. And after simplifying it, we are getting it like this. The 20x plus 16, which is equals to 21x plus 12, and after transposing 12 to the LHS and 20x to the RHS, because they are minimum values, so lower values, so we are transferring them from other sides to other side. So here their signs will be different, so we are getting the simplified form as 16 minus 12, which is equals to 21 minus 20x. And here we know that 21x minus 20x, it is going to be simply x, and 16 minus 12, it is 4. So therefore, we getting the direct value of x, which is 4. And now put this value in their present ages, where the present age of Hari is 5x and the present age of Harry is 7x. So by putting this value, we are getting the ages of Hari and Harry, which are 20 years and 28 years respectively. So you know this multiplication, 5 4s are 20 by keeping the value of x, then 7 4s are 28. So these are the ages of these two persons. Then next example is like this. The denominator of a rational number is greater than its numerator by 8. So here denominator, condition for denominator is given, which is greater than the numerator by 8, and if numerator is increased by 17, then denominator is decreased by 1. So here increased means addition and decreased means subtraction, and then their ratio is 3/2. Then we have to find out that particular rational number. So here I am going to consider that the numerator is variable, in the form of variable. So let the numerator of this rational number is x. Numerator of this rational number is x. Therefore, its denominator is going to be x plus 8, because it is more than the numerator by factor 8. So therefore denominator will be x plus 8. Now the given rational number is written like this, x upon x plus 8 in the form of numerator and denominator, x upon x plus 8. And now according to question, we have to increase the numerator by 17 and decrease the denominator by 1, and then their ratio is 3 upon 2. So increasing means adding. So numerator is x, so we have to add 17 to that numerator, and we have to decrease the denominator by 1. So denominator is x plus 8, so we are decreasing 1, that means subtracting 1, then we are getting it as a 3 upon 2. Now here you can subtract this x plus 8 minus 1, which is x plus 7, so it is the simplified form. Now again you can divide, that means you can transpose those denominators to either side, or you can multiply both sides with the help of denominators. So I am using that only step, which is multiplying both sides by 2 into x plus 7. 2 into x plus 7, we are going to get it like this: 2 inside the bracket x plus 17, which is equals to 3 inside the bracket x plus 7, and by simplifying it, we are getting it like this: 2x plus 34, which is equals to 3x plus 21. Now we have to just transpose the terms. So here again I am going to transpose 21 to the LHS and 2x to the RHS. So after transposing it, we are getting it like this: 34 minus 21, which is equals to 3x minus 2x, and by subtracting this, we know that 34 minus 21, it is 13, and 3x minus 2x, that is x, that is x. So therefore we are getting x is equals to 13 as a value of variable, and that x is only the numerator of our rational number. So therefore the numerator of rational number is going to be 13, and denominator is greater than by numerator by factor 8. So 13 plus 8, 21 is the denominator, and therefore the given rational number is 13 upon 21 is the given rational number. And in this way we can solve the last example from the exercise 2.6. So I hope you understand all the examples. You can watch previous videos also from the links. Now this is the last example from exercise 2.6 as well as from the chapter number 2. So in the next video we are going to start the new lesson, which is comparing the quantities. So stay tuned with us, and please like, subscribe and share our page so you can get the future updates from our page. So again, thanks for watching.